Hey, welcome back to this tutorial about drawing a floor plan. This is the part 3. Here, I'm going to insert the doors in the drawing and teach you some tricks to do this process faster. Let's see. As we have created doors in the part 2 of this tutorial, we can easily insert a door by going to the block panel, click in this icon and select the door. I want to insert the first one in this room, and as I know it's located at 5 cm from this wall, I know it's here if I'm using the grid and have the snap mode turned on. But be careful. If I click at this moment while the midpoint is appearing on the screen, the door will automatically snap to that position. And this means I have to turn off the object snap temporarily. And I can easily do it by pressing F3. Now I can click in this point. Then I do the same. I go to insert block and place it in this room, again 5 cm from the wall. Now, if we look to the floor plan, we can see that the doors are in different positions and openings. And these are the 8 ways they can be in the floor plan. So, let's use a simple method to do this easily and fast. First, I insert another door by clicking here again. Then, I want to add another door that opens in a clockwise way. And for that, I can use the command mirror. I select the objects, press enter, and draw now a vertical mirror line, for example, from this. Then, I choose no to not erase the original objects and press enter. After, I can do mirror again, by pressing enter to activate the previous command, select both doors, draw this time a horizontal mirror line, and then press enter. After, I just need now the 4 remaining ways, and if you pay attention, you realize I have to rotate them 90 degrees. For this process, I can use the command rotate, which is this icon located there. I click on it. I select all the objects. I press enter. Then I can click here, for example. I'm going to rotate until I see the vertical polar tracking. After, as I want to keep the original objects, I type C for copy and press enter. Finally, I click again to confirm its position. So, now it's easy to insert the doors in the floor plan. I'm going to type copy, as I want to keep these ones here. I select this door. And as the object snap is off, I have to zoom in to click exactly in this corner. I'm going to add this one to this room. And the distance from the wall is the same, 5 cm. After, I have to the other room, which has the same kind of door, and do the same. For the doors placed right below, they are just symmetric of the ones I just inserted. This means I can use the command mirror again, select the 4 doors, press enter, then I need to draw a horizontal mirror line in the middle of this corridor. So, as I have a separate line here, I press now F3 to turn on the object snap. I drag the pointer over the line and I can see the midpoint appearing. I click there, and while I draw the mirror line, you see the objects below appearing in the right place. Now I want to show you a different type of block references. It's the dynamic block. A dynamic block is a block reference that has parameters to perform actions. For example, in this block, I added a parameter which flips the door to its symmetric. And this icon flips it upside down. So, before starting, I want to say that dynamic blocks are a bit hard to learn, and it's not really a tip for beginners. But as I find it quite useful, I want to make a small introduction to this tool. If I go to the block panel and click in this icon that says Block Editor, this window appears, and here I can choose a block to edit. I click in Door Standard, then OK. Now we are in a specific workspace for editing blocks, and a new tab appeared in the ribbon, and here most of these icons are used for dynamic blocks. On the left, we have the block authority palette, and here we can add parameters to the block. So, for our case it's simple. I want to add a flip parameter in the middle between these two frames. For that, I have to draw first a horizontal line. So, using the command line, I go to this endpoint and draw a line until this other side. Then I press escape, I click in the flip parameter, find this midpoint and draw a vertical line. Then I click again to place the flip state 1. But as you see, it's not finished. Even I add a flip state, I need to add objects to it. But it's easy. I'm going to click in this yellow mark, double click. I select the parameter which is flip state 1. Press enter. Finally, I have to select the objects which compound the door. But the horizontal line below, I don't select, obviously. I press enter and I can delete this line. Finally, I save the block and close the editor. Okay, if I return to the floor plan and click in one of the doors, I can see the flip action and change easily the direction. Now I'm able to insert all the doors. However, there is a door in this diagonal wall which I want to show you a simple tip. It's about the UCS coordinates. Returning to the floor plan, we have to get rid first of this section of wall. As you may remember, it's easy to do. You can select this line and extend it until it reaches the line above. Next, use the command trim to erase the parts I don't need. There is more than one way to rotate objects to fit in this wall. And this time I'm going to show you how to use the UCS coordinates. If I go with the mouse and click in the UCS, I can select it. And then if I click in the blue square, I can move it to a different place. And this time, I want to place it in this diagonal wall. for example, in this point. Now, if I click in the X-axis, I can rotate it to the position that I desire. And as I want it to match the diagonal line, I can click, for example, in this midpoint or the endpoint of this line. Perfect. Now it will be very simple to insert the block. I click in Insert Block and select the door, and you realize that the door has rotated to match the UCS new position, and I can easily place it into the wall. However, as I want the door exactly in the middle of the wall, I leave it here first. Then I'm going to draw a line between the frames. And after that, I use the command move, select the door and press enter. And for the base point, I choose the midpoint of this line. And then I have to place it here. Now it's exactly in the middle of the wall. When I finish, I can return the UCS to its original position by clicking on it, go to this square, and then select World. Now it's again as it was before. Next thing, these double doors, I have to draw them separately. The dimensions are located in the file, and consequently, I can create a block reference for them. But those ones located in the toilets, I'll make for them a different process that I will show you later. So, before ending this video, I show you quickly how to draw this double door, and I think you can make it easily by yourself. Like the single door, I used the command rectangle to draw the frame, and it has the same measurements, 0.05 per 0.1 meters. Then I draw a line here with 0.7 meters of length. And for the arc, this time I use a different option, center, start, end. This means that the first point will be the center. Then, as the arcs are drawn anticlockwise, I choose for the start point this one on the right at 0.7 meters. So look how it makes the arc. Click here for the end point. Okay, as you see, I just drew half of the door, as the remaining part is simply the symmetric. And using command mirror, I select everything and press enter and draw the mirror line from the start point of the arc. Like this. So it's done. And I'm now able to create a block. For the name, I can type double door, for example. Then click in OK. Oh, I didn't select the objects. But I can do it now. It's OK. Select them all. Finally, click in OK and choose a base point. Finally, just need to insert the doors to its place. The first one will be here, but look the end point. As I don't want it there, I have to switch off the O-snap. And the location will be 5 cm from that point. The door below, I place it in this grid line. Okay, so it was everything in this video. Thank you very much for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to Cad in Black if you haven't done it yet. And if you want to keep watching this tutorial, click to go to part 4. Thank you very much, and see you next time.